9:16, welcome back to Live at 9. IV injection therapies create a sort of cocktail that claim to help treat just about anything from multiple sclerosis to cancer.
They're making some big claims. A string of clinics operate across the country and including right here in the Mid-South. Is it a new path to wellness or a fraud? Well, Randy Hutchinson with the Better Business Bureau is here, and this has caught the attention of the FTC, is that right?
Well, some of the claims that you just mentioned in particular.
Yeah.
There was this outfit, Texas-based outfit, that was saying that their IV treatments, IV cocktails they're called, it's where you actually have a drip bag and the fluids are injected right into your blood.
You should see this in the hospital, right?
Yes.
Is this a medical facility? I can't say that I would go to a strip mall and have an IV hooked up.
I think they referred to their some of their locations as clinics. I'm not sure if they're really medical clinics.
You're going to stick a needle in me. You better have a...
And again, I'm not here to give medical advice. It appears there are some uses that make sense. But back to the claims this outfit was making, they were saying that their treatments, their intravenous treatments, would help treat cancer, multiple sclerosis, diabetes, a whole bunch of other illnesses. They had pictures on their website of people in lab coats, test tubes, microscopes. They claimed to have IV bars, research labs. They said that these treatments were safe for anybody. And the FTC said no.
So basically, it's the marketing claims. No one's saying that you've got to stop. You've just got to stop advertising it.
Well, in this case, again, the problem with this particular outfit is their claims went over the top. The FTC said you don't have the scientific evidence that helps with these sorts of diseases. Said they didn't really have these labs that they claimed to have, all these pictures. They didn't really have people running around looking like they were scientists. They also said on their website and in their ads that it was safe for everybody's treatments. The FTC said no, the release form that you have people sign when it gets down to the bottom line said that you could experience complications like allergic reactions, joint pain, bleeding, and of course, probably the bigger concern, particularly when they claim that these sorts of treatments will help with the diseases we talked about, is that people may forego conventional, good prescribed
testing
treatments.
Yeah.
And take this sort of treatment instead.
Now, she was talking about the marketing aspect of this. Where does this fall under the medical aspect as far as what other organization is saying it's okay to do this other than from the trade practice?
I Googled it. I did some research on the practice in general. As I said, the FTC says it's increasing in popularity. And I saw mixed reviews. I think everybody would agree that these claims were over the top, outrageous, unsubstantiated, even dangerous. But it appears, and I'm not here, Better Business Bureau doesn't give medical advice.
Dr. Randy.
But it appears that people have found them to be useful in treating dehydration after jet lag. In fact, it appeared to me that the earliest use for these sorts of treatments were to treat hangovers.
Right. And they come to your house, from what I understand.
In this case, this particular outfit, who charged $150 to $200 a treatment, you'd either go to their place, sit in a nice, comfortable chair, have it done, or they would come to your house probably at a bit of a higher fee.
So
it seems like it's
question.
Cheaper to make really strong coffee. Not that I've ever had to do that.
Yeah, you really want to consult with a medical professional before you take these
sorts
of treatments.
I want to know what it is I'm putting
consult
in my body.
Consult with your doctor. Don't forego conventional prescribed treatments without a doctor's advice, and be sure that this treatment doesn't conflict with other treatments that you may be taking.